All right, that was Herd Focus. So every nation has the responsibility and the obligation to know who is coming in and out of his borders. Every nation has that responsibility and obligations to its citizens. Every nation. Having said that, what we witnessed in the last few days was abject cruelty. Tell me where border patrols are trained to use their reins as whips and to grab people and throw them into rivers and to use horses to threaten and dehumanize them. It looked like they were rounding up cattle. And I can guarantee you this, if they were using those whips on horses like that, the nation would be incensed. Every nation has the responsibility to guard and to protect and to know who's coming in and out of his borders. But according to the Geneva Convention, we also have an obligation to treat refugees and people seeking asylum with respect and decency. The 1980 Refugee Act says exactly that. What part of treating them with dignity, people who legally are here to seek asylum, what part of treating them with dignity is using horses and whips? And some of those border patrolmen looked like they enjoyed it. They did it gleefully. Cruelty seems to be the point. Absent a coherent, cogent immigration policy, this is what we get. Whether they are whipping Haitian refugees or South American refugees are being put in cages, cruelty seems to be the point. And depending on where you are, it can be abjectly cruel. Now, Governor Abbott decided to weaponize the Border Patrol to do exactly that. The people are not breaking the law when they cross the border to seek asylum. And if you look at what's happened in Haiti and what has gone on there from natural disasters to assassinations, thousands of them have left to seek asylum to do exactly what the Geneva Convention and our own 1980 Refugee Act says they could. As a matter of fact, many of those Haitian refugees were not, they went to Mexico to get food, and they were coming back to under the underpass to seek asylum when they were there was an attempt to thwart them from doing exactly that by the Border Patrol. If you notice, they weren't running away. They had food in plastic containers that they had just got from Del Rio, Mexico, and they were going back to seek asylum legally. But cruelty seems to be the point. Cruelty seems to be what we have decided in lieu of a coherent immigration policy. This is what we do. And Abbott wanted exactly that to appease his right-wing nut jobs. From everything from telling people that they're rapists and they're murderers, from caravans of immigrants, now we have Haitians. Cruelty seems to be the point. They are doing what they are enabled to do according to the Geneva Convention and our own 1980 Refugee Act. They can come here to seek asylum when they're running away from terrible conditions back at home. And what could be more terrible than an earthquake that shatters the very foundation of a nation and political upheaval? They are here doing what they are able to do legally according to international law and our own law. And if that is what border patrols trained to use their reins like whips and horses, it looked like a slavery roundup. They could not have been aware of the optics. Or maybe they were, and that was the point. Putting kids in cages, dehumanizing them, and whipping Haitians is exactly the point. They're going to thwart their own laws, the international law and the law that we set forth in 1980, that refugees can seek asylum here. They can. I'm sure people didn't want to have that dangerous trek from Haiti through South America up through Mexico only to be dehumanized at our borders. They weren't crashing the borders. They went to get food and they were coming back. How many people you know breaking the law with bags of food in their hands? It is people. They are doing what they are able to do according to international law and the law of the United States of America, where they can legally seek asylum. Whether they get that or not is an open question. To be treated inhumanely is not. That is not a question. Emma Lazarus, the statue at the bottom of Liberty says, give us your tired, your poor, your home, your huddled masses yearning to breathe free. The reparate refuge of your teeming shores. Send these, the tempted toss, and I light my lamp by the golden door. If we do not believe that, say no more vacancies, especially for black and brown people. Because absent a coherent, cohesive immigration policy, this is the point. We know that the Border Patrol is ripe with supremacists, ripe with people who want to do what they did. Those people are doing what they're legally able to do. And they don't need to be dehumanized. They're already running from tragedy, only to be met with it here. That's a little note from the GED section. We've got the Jazz Report coming up in 15 minutes. It's the D.L. Hughley Show.